choice. This is what happens when you fuck with us. We warned you too. We fucking warned you. You live and you learn. That's what Pops always said. You and Rush gotta learn.
I don't like what I'm seeing.
Get out of here! Now!
This feels real familiar.
Like we've been down this road before? Oh, relax. Stay a while. Oh, look at that. See how easy you can be to get along with? I wanted you to understand that. I wanted you to see that things could have ended differently if you just listened to us and went away. Instead, you chose the stick. Here it is.
Spend all night wiping those hopes and dreams off my boots. You know, before you showed up, everything was fucking great. And you came along with your fancy train and your fancy people trying to make this place into something that is never gonna be. And when we tried to be reasonable, you thought it'd be a good idea to stir up the pot.
Over and over.
All because you thought there was a hope for your future? There's no hope for you. No future. Idiot.
Michelle, Louise, I need you to listen to me.
Why? You're not coming with us.
I don't have a choice. Your father...
Daddy says if you're not with us, you're against us.
It's not that simple.
Yes, it is. Gotta go, Mom. Dad's here.
Michelle, you two need to take care of each other. Because your dad, he won't. He has a lot of big plans, but everything he does ends in violence.
Dad solves problems.
He creates them. He leaves a trail of bodies behind him. He doesn't care who gets hurt. Don't end up like him. Promise me you won't be like him.
You saw that though, right? I fucking hawked out like that?
Everything was normal until they went up north. Maybe it's time we ask them freaks some questions.
Thank you. Rush, I'm sorry. I'm sorry I got on that train. I'm sorry I brought you to Hope County. We'll always remember you. You took a risk for us, and it cost you your life. This is all my fault. Rush, I promise we'll make you proud.
He was a good man. Selfless. And you... You did everything you could. Oh, those fucking twins are always a step ahead. We need another angle. I'm gonna go check on Carmina. When you want to hear what I have in mind, come talk to me.
To help us get those highwaymen dead.
The things that keep me going are the good parts of our path.
Can we talk? We're all shaken up by the loss of Rush, but we can't let up. As much as I hated the idea of talking to Joseph, I have to admit that having New Eden attack the highwaymen has given us a chance to blindside them. I was talking to the scouts. It seems that out by the old orchards, there's a place the highwaymen bet on fights. The promoter out there claims to be close to the twins. Who knows if it's true, but it's worth checking out.
Hello, mister.
There's a family of farmers tucked away in the corner of the valley. They're the proud owners of the biggest fucking boar I've ever seen. You ought to make sure the highwaymen don't get their hands on it.
We lost a lot of produce, but it's nothing we can't come back from, so long as we can keep the highwaymen at bay.
I remember the first time I saw a blossom on it.
got a deal for you.
Uh-huh. You got a chip on your shoulder the size of Texas, I can tell. I think we got some twins in common, right? They teamed up with me a while back, you know. I'm like their right-hand man, pretty much. We got this thing where we owe each other every now and then. You know, it's friendly. It's like a give-and-take type deal. The thing is, I owe him this time around, uh-oh. And I'm in a little, financial, trouble. All I need is a sure thing, and boom, hey, no problem. Now, here's a skinny. There's some fighters in this arena, and I need somebody who can give them a run for their money. But first, I need to know you could throw a punch, really haymake the shit out of somebody, you know? So take a swing at this machine here to measure what you got. Now, I broke it when I gave it a shot. Let's see if you got half as much. A fucking punch. Hate to be on the bad end of you. Let's put it to use. Stash your weapons. Obviously, we can't take them where we're headed. And, follow me.
Part of me feels bad for Ethan.
Come on, it ain't far. Used to be a fighter myself. I wasn't that bad back in the day. I went on a little winning streak. Knocked out 17 guys in a row. Huh? 7 fucking team. Had to quit. Too lethal. Punched the last guy so hard, he farted his brains out. Seriously. Guys, seriously. His brains. And that made me pull up short. I had to think to myself, I got a gift, but I can't control it. Okay, here we are. Head on in, and my associate will help you get processed. Make nice. Don't look him in the eye. After you're done, I'll open the door for you and meet you back at the weapons cache. So go get him, chump. Champ.
You. Yeah, I'm here for you. I know what's the skinny around here. Little Leffer sent you, huh? Follow me.
First rule of the fighting pit is you gotta tell everyone you know. Get the word out, get exposure, all that.
I've been craving that teeth-breaking crunch.
Gotta go right for the face every time. They never see it coming.
Scabs all protein course.
Hey, you need a fighting name before you go in there, so we know who to bet against.
That lollipop! Clearly a lollipop! It's all over their face!
All right, squirt. Lollipop it is. Get into the ring, Lollipop.
Here comes motherfuckers! Let it is human sacrifice! Lollipop!
You're dead, Lollipop. You're alive now, but you're still dead. Lollipop! I bet Lollipop.
That's too soon!
There's a nasty shock waiting for you in there.
This is gonna be a slaughter.
All right, you filthiest thug fucks. Welcome to the best fighting pit dug this side of the radiation clouds. Let's stop fucking around and welcome our new friend Lollipop to the party! Let's hope they last longer than the last one!
Everywhere counts!
Hey,
Thank you. to help.
Over here.
You think you're clever, huh? You think you're hot shit? Because that's exactly what you were back there. You fought great. I think you're the kind of asshead I could work with. The asset. I mean asset.
Shit we could get up to together. Oh, great things. Great things.
I know you got shit to shovel with Mickey and Lou. I can get you close to them. And then you could take care of business. I'll figure it out. Don't worry, Slick. I'm gonna make this happen for you. I gotta put on my thinking cap. Need some space to figure this out, so you run along. Can't think with you nose breathing over my shoulder. I'll be in touch. He's all that. You want the twins, right? You want to get close enough to count the nose hairs? Well, I got a way to do that. Now, normally, I'd just walk you up and introduce you to the twins straight off. But I'm on the outs with them right now. Told them they were fucking up and they got all huffy. It's a whole thing. That's not important. What's important is that now the twins are all over this guy Frank. Like he's their best friend or something. They even made him the fucking warden of the prison. You believe that? Well, they know me and him don't get along. He's such a dick. But what it is Lou has a thing for me. And she wants to make me jealous, okay? Or why else would they even talk to that asshole? So the number one part of the plan is you gotta kill Frank. And here's how we do it. He's the prison warden, right? So I take you to the prison as a prisoner. That gets you close to Frank, and you just fucking take him out. Take that motherfucker out. I'll explain the rest of the plan on the way. Trust me, it's surefire. Just stash your gear here. The prisoners don't got weapons. Then jump in the truck, and I'll drive you in.
To set things right in this world, we're gonna have to do all kinds of things we didn't expect.
Hey, what do you know? Orange is your color. Hop in the back, let's go. So you're wondering how killing Frank gets you close to the twins, right? Now, the Demolition Derby's coming up. The winner of the Derby gets invited to the fancy-ass dinner with all the highwaymen bigwigs. Win the Derby, and you got an express ticket to the twins' personal space. The problem is, the Derby's got all the drivers they need. We gotta open up a spot in the lineup. Well, guess what? Frank's all set to drive in the Derby. That's right. You see the genius of the plan? You take Frank out, and boom, suddenly the Derby's a driver short. So happens, I know a guy who's tight with a gal. Anyway, I can get you that spot on the Derby.
first, Frank's gotta go. I guess without any weapons, you'll have to improvise a way to kill that motherfucker. I'll let you work out the details.
Hey, it's Lil Fucker. Imagine that, Lil Fucker in his garbage truck. Hope you got something good in the truck bed there, Lil Fucker. Hope it's worth a fucking while.
The hell you want, Lil Fucker?
Hey, nice to see you too. Jeez. I got a prisoner with me. What do you think?
It's your ass in the weeds if they're a problem. Bring him in.
Don't balls it up in there, okay, Slick? Don't die!
Something, and I want to know what it is.
I'm with you on that, but they can't tell you anything unless you ask more questions. Let me handle this.
I know what I'm doing.
Hate to barge in.
We're busy!
I know, but somebody who looks important wants to talk.
How important?
Hey, shut up!
I don't want to hear this.
Make sure his shit isn't working! Get back to it!
It's all under control.
I'll handle this one. The fuck you still doing here?
Thank you.
get anything as big and bad as us without some good old-fashioned prisoner jobs. Labor. Don't get anything as big and bad as us without some good old-fashioned prisoner as a job.
God, I'm so sore. Hope they don't figure out I'm not strong enough to keep this up.
Twins have those scabs in the weeds now. Won't have any idea what hit them.
Help! Help me! Help! 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 Help won't get anything as big and bad as us without some real attack.
Back up! Any moment! Hit him harder! I heard that those cultists follow some kind of wizard living in the north.
like to play it loud and proud, Slick. But I can't get caught in this shit, so I'll meet you down the road once you get out.
That asshole in his fucking pride. I cannot overstate how much I wanted Frank to die. Thank you. Can't believe that idiot thought he could drive in the Derby. I could drive in the Derby. I could run the Derby. I know more about cars than any of them. I once built a car out of nothing but a kitchen sink. That spot in the Derby is yours now. And that's gonna get you up close and personal with Mickey and Lou. All I gotta do is finagle you a halfway decent set of wheels, and you're good to go. Look, we don't want to be seen hanging around together, so you gotta move on out of here. Now, don't worry. I'll be in touch real soon.
You